As you post, it's a good idea to consider the terms of service, particularly as a content creator. Not all platforms are created the same. I've mentioned that I regularly use YouTube, and I see value in its huge audience that it's collected. What I don't necessarily like are the rights you're giving up when you post to YouTube. There's a whole bunch of stuff in the terms of service that you might not be comfortable with as a video creator. You should read those. Now, I can't tell you what's right for you, and I do put some content onto YouTube, but I show great care. On the other hand, Vimeo, a paid service that I use, has very different terms of service that give me more control over my content. You have to find what works for you or your clients. For example, I don't post my clients' work to YouTube unless they ask us to. But if they use YouTube and upload the video, I'll easily reshare that on social media. And these are some of the intricacies you have to think about. What goes in your portfolio and is in a password-protected area on a site like Vimeo, and what is out there for the world to see on a platform like YouTube. So this comes down to terms of service. Those terms of service really give you a wide range of rights, and they're not always the same. YouTube is a great platform that allows a lot of people to share content and reach a huge audience. But if you read the terms of service, it's a little scary. The terms I'm sharing here may not be the most current ones. They do change from time to time. In fact, all of the time. But when you read them, look for terms like this that pop out. You'll see words like sub-licensable, transferable, without limitation. This means that your content can be monetized by them. They have the ability to take what you've given them and license it to others, to transfer the rights to other parties without limits. So if you post something to YouTube and decide you don't want it monetized, well, they actually can still monetize it and run ads against it, even though you're not seeing any revenue. Or you might decide you want to take content down, but if someone has reshared that comment or taken it and used it to make a derivative work, it's not going to come off the servers necessarily. Now, you can make copyright claims and other information, and YouTube has gotten a lot better at protecting copyright. But as an individual content creator, you give up a lot of rights when you post. I always suggest you take a look at terms of service, and it's not just for places like YouTube. You're going to want to explore what rights you're giving up, and different platforms have different rights. Generally speaking, the ones that you pay a membership fee to are going to be very different. The rights you find, for example, on a site like 500px are very different than the rights you see on Instagram. What happens when you post a video to Vimeo is very different than when you post a video to YouTube. These may not bother you now, but as you start to build up your portfolio or you're doing work for hire and creating content for other companies, it is something you have to be aware of. So take the time to read them over, and if things don't make sense, might be a chance to talk to a lawyer and get some advice on what's right for you and your company.